Hello, good people of the internet. It is episode 11 of season 4. This is Trial by Magic. Guilty. My crystal ball. Remember her? She's dead. Remember her? I didn't see nothing in that crystal ball. And the source is not dead, but he might as well be because he hasn't been in it for a while. This is Trial by Magic. Last time we had a page from a story. And we had a magical door. That door, by the way, although we may never see it again, was really cool. Like, really cool. Just plopped down, opened up into a magical place. Ah, I love it. More things like that. Or maybe they just keep the door in the attic with their bikes and chairs. I ain't seen nobody on a bike. Have you? Maybe Grams owned the bike.
Is that all that you brought?
That's all that I own. That and a bike.
Anyway, this is episode 11. Looking forward to it. I'm expecting a trial. I'm expecting magic. I'm expecting humorous moments. And sisterly camaraderie. Hey, and if Daryl's in it, maybe we can continue the Cole wants to be help out Daryl a bit. I don't know if that's going to be a thing, but it could be. Ooh, food. Usually means Piper's making stuff. Yep.
Coming through.
Hey, I was using that.
Well, I'm late and I need caffeine, so sue me.
Where are you going?
2 weeks of jury duty and suddenly she's lawyery.
Jury duty.
I'd be tired too if I had to decide whether or not someone lived or died. What's your decision?
Is it a murder trial?
You know I can't talk about the case.
She can touch all the evidence objects.
When do you think he's gonna come back? He said he needed some time to find himself and figure
find
out
himself.
Who he was without his demon side.
She just agreed to marry him and he's off on walkabout.
It's closing argument.
Already? That was fast. Maybe it's only natural to be curious.
She can't tell you.
Nobody keeps secrets better than us. We are the mistresses of secrets.
Let's just say it will be my supreme pleasure to send that murdering bastard straight to hell.
Maybe he's innocent.
Hey.
Hi.
Who's this?
Glenn, it's so good to
Glenn.
See you.
I'm done with Australia finally, and I'm actually thinking about Nepal. And
he was on walkabout.
Stop by and see how you're doing.
Where are you staying?
I don't know yet, actually.
Oh, wait, we know who this guy is. What am I talking? I'm not. What? It's Glenn. Of course it's Glenn. He was in the other episode. Remember? And they were talking. The one with the knight. The knight to remember. And he was off to Australia. And he's back from Australia. I thought we'd never see him again. Here's me acting like he's a new person. It's Glenn. Of course it's Glenn. We remember Glenn. He was fine. And he's still fine. So don't have to worry about him bringing back any ancient Egyptian kangaroos from Australia. Because Glenn's just a normal dude with no supernatural stuff. Don't steal the book, Glenn. You're in the house. You're inside the house. That's the first step to stealing the book, but also the first step to winning the hearts of the nation and page. Have I got that all out of my system? Yeah. I want to see this jury duty stuff. I want to see who's on trial. I want to see if it is a really bad person. If they get away with it, or if it's a really innocent person and Phoebe has to sort of have her mind changed. Is she going to use witchy powers in the trial somehow? It is called witch trial. Cole. I can understand the second after Black is Cole. If Cole needed time to find out about himself. We've had a lot of episodes where he's adjusted and it seemed like his first priority was to get Phoebe to agree to marry him. And then when she said yes, he was out of there. Scared of commitment. That's what it is. Isn't it cool? So who knows where he went to. He'll probably come back with some powers that we don't know about. Anyway, this has been a Glenn pause. How you doing, Glenn? Did Australia treat you well? Don't steal nothing. Except the hearts of Paige. Just the one heart.
Good. You'll stay here. What?
Oh, boyfriend, stay here. Piper.
Paige.
It's Glenn. He's fine. What? You've seen Madam.
Well, we usually don't have house guests because of all of the obvious reasons.
I also pay rent here.
There is no rent.
Damn it.
An expression.
The defendant has no alibi, no credible explanation for how he was able to lead the police directly to his ex-wife's body.
He's a psychic.
Other than his psychic vision?
He's a psychic, Phoebe.
No, premonition.
Phoebe.
That's it. That's what Mr. Provozoli expects you to believe.
I believe him.
People 17, the murder weapon.
What is it?
Return the verdict.
Oh, hey.
You know you must.
Him. Medusa. A Medusa tattoo.
Are you all right, ma'am?
I'd like to see the defendant's...
Ma'am, are you all right?
Arm? This shouldn't take long, do you hear that? Phoebe will be the only one saying he's innocent.
Hey, I just got a premonition. We'll be out of here in time for lunch. So let's just take a vote and get out of here.
As the foreman,
all those
my
in
job.
Favor of guilty? Yeah. One, guilty. Two, three, eight, nine, ten.
No,
11.
Phoebe, it's just 11.
Come on, lady, what's it gonna be?
He doesn't have a tattoo. What are you talking about, lady?
I have to go to the bathroom.
Maybe the foreman will be on her side.
Leo!
Phoebe, what?
Order to the matter.
See, we should be using Leo more often.
Okay, now I didn't see his face, but he had this tattoo on his arm, like a Medusa's head with
yeah,
snakes.
Yeah, Medusa.
Do we hunt killers that aren't demons?
Well, I had that premonition for a reason. Just because the killer isn't supernatural.
Hey there, Glenn!
We're talking about our play.
I'll just take Glenn to the kitchen and show him where to make a sandwich.
A sandwich.
Is he staying here?
Yeah, he's Glenn. He's Glenn!
What the hell's going on in there?
Glenn is fine.
That time of the month.
Look, what's it gonna be?
Innocent.
Well, consider the possibility that the defendant might actually be a psychic.
What?
He could be.
You're the foreman. Make her vote.
Can't review the evidence.
He can't make her vote.
I've been worried about you. The vibe that I've been getting since I got here doesn't make me worry any less. Talk to me, Paige. What's going on?
Don't tell him too much. Do it quickly.
Daryl got us that thing. Are you coming?
Don't mention Daryl if he's not in the episode.
I'll see you later.
Excuse me.
Paige, keeping your secret has to be the most important thing.
Which is why I just lied to my best friend.
That's not good enough. It's irresponsible to leave him here.
Paige. Oh, I'm interrupting again.
Yeah.
She always that friendly?
Yeah, pretty much. I'll see you later.
Piper never let Dan stay here. She didn't even let him in the house. Most of the time.
Exactly who you people are. And all you need to know is that we might be able to save your client. Isn't that enough?
Yeah, lawyer. Stupid lawyer, dude.
Nothing short of a miracle can help him now.
Show me your arms, lawyer.
These people wanted to talk to you. Was there anything in your premonition to indicate who the killer might be?
You actually believe me?
Yes.
I don't need a premonition to know who killed Angie. It's Wyke. He owns a magic club where I performed.
No. Oh. Let's go find him.
Well, he killed her with one of my knives to frame me.
Look out, Nancy Drew, coming through.
Oh, we're out.
Hey, what are you doing in here?
Oh, we can see his arms.
Who the hell are you?
And leave.
Oh. Seems like he's the guy.
A fair and just verdict. We have to analyze every...
It seems a simple episode, you know? There could be a small twist, but it does seem like that's the guy. Whenever magicians are involved, you know, you can't trust anything. But You know, like the magician could, I don't know actually what he could do. Draw a tattoo on his arm before killing his wife and then wash it off to frame the other guy by relying on the fact that one of the jury members will have a psychic vision of it. That seems far-fetched, doesn't it? I think we should just, we're going to just say it's as simple as it is. Funny episode where Phoebe is the only one who thinks the guy is innocent and she has to convince everybody. How is she going to convince anybody? Maybe there's something in the evidence that could help. And then we got poor little Glenn back at the house. Snooping Glenn. Don't snoop, Glenn. Don't go upstairs. You can look at all the pictures. You can be freaked out by all the pictures. Water some plants. You know, earn your keep. And don't break the clock. We have very strict rules in the manor. I love that he couldn't find the kitchen. Their whole downstairs is just one giant room. There are no doors that I've ever seen. It's just one giant room. And kitchen isn't too hard to find in that case. I wonder if he's going to stay around or if we're going to tell him anything. So far, I'm not suspicious. He hasn't had any weird looks when he's been on his own. He's acted completely normally. And they've known each other since they were children. So he's playing a long game if he's a demon. You know what I'm saying?
Is it so hard for you to believe that that's possible? That there are powers beyond what we can see? Oh.
Can you prove it to him?
We all need to believe that magic exists. Tanya, why are you wearing an angel pin?
I don't know. Just because my mother gave it to me.
Why did she give it to you?
To protect you.
To watch over me.
That's magic.
All those in favor of another vote.
I'll vote again. Ooh, Leo.
Nature calls.
Oh, no.
No, you don't.
I can't believe it. Quick.
We found the real killer. Okay, well, you gotta hurry because I am dying in there.
You and Paige could use your powers to scare him into confessing.
Can somebody find me a plunger? Oh, great. Okay, go. Piper, you up here? What's the emergency?
Cool book.
What are you doing up here?
Look at your cool books.
I found some bags labeled pig's feet, frog tongue.
It's continental.
So I decided to take a little look around.
Look, I can explain everything. Just have to explain it later, because if Piper finds us up here, she's gonna freak.
Your new sisters have you messing with the occult, and you're worried about how they're gonna freak?
It's a hobby.
We're not messing around with the occult.
What's she gonna tell
them? Witches.
These girls have you brainwashed. I mean, how do you even know that these are your sisters?
I am still the same old Paige, only now if I make a rhyme, magic happens.
Yeah, you gotta be careful with the rhyming.
There is a spell in here.
Harmless one?
To stretch the imagination.
You're gonna cast a spell on me.
With your permission. Let mind and body soar to heights not reached before. Let limits stretch that you may catch a new truth to explore.
Did it work?
Don't feel any different. No worry.
Oh, he's turned into a stretchy man. Mr. Fantastic. Cool, eh?
You showed him the book? I trust Glenn. But you're trusting him with a secret that is all of ours, not just yours.
He discovered it.
Because she left him in the house. Because she let him stay in the house in the first place.
Let's calm down. We have a lot of work to do and not a lot of time to do it with. I need to go check on Phoebe.
Can we undo his stretchiness?
And Cupid! Not a myth! I mean, he doesn't actually use arrows, but he's real too.
Bailiff!
What are you doing?
We don't have to declare a hung jury after all.
She's insane. Clinically insane.
We're asking that she be dismissed and that you bring in one of the alternates.
And you all agree?
Yes. Mm-hmm. What am I doing it?
If I can convince you, all of you.
How's she gonna do that?
That magic really does exist. Will that be enough reasonable doubt for an acquittal?
You're late for your shrink.
What's she gonna do?
If you fail, you vote guilty with the rest of us.
High stakes.
It's a deal. I'm gonna summon the dead.
Oh, jeez. Who are we summoning? The murdered victim?
Okay, just remember, you play good witch, I play bad witch. So it's okay to show our powers to a murderer, but not to Glenn.
Yeah. Nice trick.
What do you want?
We want a confession. I've never seen her like this, pal. You might want to talk.
Yeah.
What do you say we move on to some body parts?
Oh, okay. All right.
You got him.
I killed her. She was ready to march the cops down to Pier 86. If I hadn't have killed her, they would have.
Who's they?
The cops?
You don't want to know.
Try me.
I want to know. Oh, he's using his magics.
He's pretty good.
Where'd he go? Trapdoor?
There's gonna be a trapdoor.
Oh, it's the rat! It's the rat!
I can explain!
Ratman!
You told the witches everything.
They'll never find out about you guys.
No. Oh, he's a rat!
I don't get it. Where'd he go?
Yeah, well, at least we got his taped confession.
Hey, Glenn! You doing okay?
Well, without Wykes, the confession is no good. I mean, now I actually sound like Nancy Drew.
We have no idea where he is.
That noise.
Noise?
Stretchy noise.
Paige, what's going on?
Nothing. Nothing's going on, Piper. Hey!
You! You cast a spell on him? Are you crazy?
Somebody is.
Just trying to have fun.
Thought he was being funny. Nobody got hurt.
Are we gonna erase his brain?
Yeah, how's Phoebe doing?
Not so good. She's trying to summon the victim, Angela.
But it's okay for Phoebe to tell an entire room of strangers?
An entire room of jerks.
Stay here, order a pizza. I'll be back soon.
Did you ever see anything like that, dude? Oh, Rad was here. How did he get in? How did he know where to go?
I seek your guidance. I ask that you commune with me.
Nothing.
Beloved spirit,
you're
Angela.
A crackpot, that's lady.
Bailiff.
Commune with me and move among us. BB, 11 jurors. I know, but this guy is innocent. So if you guys aren't here to help me summon Angela.
We are, if Leo will help us clean it up after we're done.
Using memory dust on people.
Good job. Introducing that just when we need to erase Glenn's memory. Good job bringing that up. So I presume we're going to be using it on Glenn. Which is a shame. He's just having fun. Did he find out pretty too quickly, maybe? Depends on how long he's going to stay. Maybe he's going to go up back off on his journeys. What is it, pixie dust? But this is cool. Show the jury. I'd love to see the jury freak out and then all vote that he's innocent and then get their memories erased. And they're like, why did we do that?
Oh my god. This is brilliant.
Why don't you just use it all the time?
Because you don't know what you might be erasing.
This is an emergency.
Okay.
We ask that you commune with us and move amongst us.
See you later.
Okay, thank you.
Look!
Dear God.
What happened? Where am I?
Who killed you?
We summoned you. What are you doing?
This is some kind of trick.
Stan could see things. The past, the future. So he didn't kill you?
No. The club owner did.
Yeah, club owner.
Andrew Wyke.
Blessed be. Shall we vote?
Not guilty.
This lawyer has no idea.
The defendant is hereby released. This court is adjourned.
The judge is like, what the hell? That makes no sense.
Dustin Leo.
So you guys have told people about being witches lots of times.
Can't you guys just enjoy saving this innocent for a minute and a half before getting back to the great debate?
Well, it's not over. The killer is still out there somewhere.
He's right here.
Glenn!
Power three of them.
You have 1 hour to deliver the tape.
Holy shitballs. That's gonna cost a lot to replace.
Oh my god, if anything happens to him,
we won't let it.
Hey, look, so if we go to their bosses and we threaten to expose their entire operation, they're not gonna be very pleased with him.
Just do me a favor and keep him alive at the club until I get back.
I don't know if this is the right place.
Where's all that steam coming from? Ooh, rats. Some of them could be actual rats.
Maybe you've heard of us. The Charmed Ones?
Yeah, you better scurry. I prefer them in rat form.
We're listening.
He's very fast. Tape.
Where's our friend, Mouse Man?
If anything happens to me, anything at all, Doreen will decapitate him.
Oh, jeez. Yeah.
Now let him go.
I'm a rat. What'd you expect?
Freeze him! Oh, oh. Who's burning him?
Only copy?
Yes.
Guess we'll call this one a draw.
See you later, rat buddy. Are we gonna sparkle dust him?
Oh, leaving so soon?
Yeah, Glenn's gonna go stay with a friend of his across the bay.
So you're gonna stick around a while?
Yeah, keep an eye out. Noogie here.
Noogie.
Glenn, I think it's time for you to go.
He's getting out. He's getting out.
Thanks for saving my life.
Uh-huh.
Bye.
He didn't get dusted.
Bye, you.
We might see him again.
I was thinking maybe we should use some of that dust on Glenn. You know, I don't want you guys to have to be nervous.
So, do you think he's gonna tell anybody?
No, we're not gonna
do
it.
And you trust him completely?
We're not gonna do it.
Yes. And so do we.
At least you have one person outside the family that you can talk to.
Oh,
yeah,
I like that.
Keep it to one.
I like that she offered and they said it was okay. So, that was Trials by Magic. They didn't have those middle words that I just said. An episode of two parts. Well, one big part and one really small part. The really small part is Glenn. Now, is Glenn going to be Paige's person? We got Cole, we got Leo. Paige is currently the only person who's could be dating various people. But it seems like from this ending that Glenn's not going around. He's not taking back off to Australia, you know? He's going to be close by. So maybe the writers are thinking of keeping him around for more stories. So he could be Paige's boyfriend. He could be a one-season wonder. The one thing we do know is that he's not evil. Because he got access to the book. And all he did was flip through it. Unless he's playing a really, really, really complicated long game. Like our buddy Daryl. That I just don't, you know, I don't understand it. He seemed like a decent guy, you know. A bit mischievous, he's finding things a bit too funny, you know, especially with his stretch powers. And I thought for sure they were gonna introducing the magic dust. I was like, they're for sure they're gonna use it on Glenn, aren't they? But they didn't, which I'm happy about. And they talked about it, which I'm happy about. And is that door going to look the way it currently looks in the next episode? That's what I'm curious about. Because it's brighter. Where the wood is at the moment, the wood is unvarnished, you know? It's going to be a change if they keep it like that. I'll be curious about that for sure. The other part of the episode was the trial by magic part. With the jury, and it was fun. A lot of it was fun. I can't believe that the way we convinced them was to actually summon the ghost of the murdered woman, who could tell them that, hey, my husband didn't do this. Imagine if we could do that for every murder trial. That'd be great. Just summon the victim. Phoebe could be doing a lot of good in the world. No innocent person would ever go to prison. If the charmed ones could just summon the ghost of the person who died. So, I know they're busy fighting demons and saving the world from apocalypses, but they could also do a lot of good in the criminal justice system. And actually, that magician guy, he could use his psychic gift. He should be on Daryl's payroll. Help him solve a bunch of cases. Touch this. Getting anything? You know? Instead of going to college, that's what Phoebe should have been doing. Remember when she was sort of doing that with her, the one day she worked at Buckland's? She was like, whoop! Yeah, touching everything? Whoop! But is it, in Phoebe's case, the visions are, she doesn't have control of them as much as she would like or that we might think. She seems to be only given visions for specific reasons. In this episode's case, to save the life of an innocent guy. So, you know, if she went to work for the cops, maybe she wouldn't get that many visions, or she wouldn't be able to help out in every single case. But hey, if we solve the demon problem, maybe we can move on to earthly problems. I like the good witch, bad witch routine. I thought Piper was genuinely menacing. Good job, Piper. You know, she was playing the role well. I was like, is she going to hurt this man? Then I remembered they were doing good witch, bad witch, and I was like, oh, no, of course she isn't. But that guy got turned into a rat and eaten by rats. They should have turned him into a piece of cheese. That would have been less gruesome. And then it was kind of a confusing resolution to that story. Rat King came in and burned the other rat guy, and, you know, he was like, yeah, this is good enough. Deal, don't bother us again. So, that was that. Next episode is called Lost and Bound. What could that refer to? Well, the bound makes me think that people will be tied up. That usually happens in a kidnapping. Maybe there's going to be a kidnapping. Somebody's going to go missing. And they're going to be tied up. Something like that. Maybe. Maybe we can get Daryl involved. They don't mention him if he's not in it. They mention both Daryl and Cole. Cole just went off wandering. To find himself. Makes sense. It does make sense for his character. Absolutely. I wonder if he's going to discover anything and be in any way changed when he gets back, or if it'll just be exactly like it always was. Wonder if he'll find his purpose, or if he'll bring back some secret powers or anything. I think that's all I want to say about the episode. It was just sort of a fun little episode. I thought they might do something more with the magic. I thought there might be a little twist with the magic. But apart from, the funniest part was the other guy doing the cloud of smoke to get away. That was the only magic thing we actually saw, though. I thought maybe they could have, I don't know, somehow cleverly worked the murder in with magic. Or some sort of something that doesn't quite look like what it appears to be. But it was pretty straightforward. I was even doubting the tattoo vision. I was like, well, you know, if you want to frame somebody that you know has vision powers, you know, you could do something with the tattoo or something. Very recognizable, though. The Medusa. Everybody knew it was a Medusa tattoo. Which is cool. And that bailiff that I thought I knew from another episode? Nope. Not that I can see here. Not on his IMDb, anyway. Yeah. I had to be very careful with that. Very careful. I saw his name as the the episode was ending, I was like, that's his name, I'll just Google that one, because I didn't want to be Googling the actors in this episode, because if you see the actors in this episode, you see Glenn and you're like, well, oh, he's only in this one and the previous one he was in. Okay, shit, that spoils the rest of the... I want it to be a mystery whether or not he reappears or not. I assume he will. He's a good actor, you know, he plays well on screen. But then again, we never saw Clay again, so what do I know? So, I'll see you next time for Lost and Bound.